a WikiVidi Documentaries production. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Enjoy. Labyrinth, film. Labyrinth is a 1986 musical dark fantasy adventure film directed by Jim Henson, executive produced by George Lucas, and based upon conceptual designs by Brian Froud. The film revolves around 15-year-old Sarah's quest to reach the center of an enormous otherworldly maze to rescue her infant brother Toby, whom Sarah wished away to Jareth, the Goblin King. With the exception of Connelly and Bowie, most of the film's significant characters are played by puppets produced by Jim Henson's Creature Shop. The film started as a collaboration between Henson and Froud, with ideas for the film first being discussed between them following a screening of their previous collaboration, The Dark Crystal. Terry Jones of Monty Python wrote the first draft of the film's script early in 1984, drawing on Froud's sketches for inspiration. Various other scriptwriters, including Laura Phillips, Lucas, Dennis Lee, and Elaine May, subsequently rewrote and made additions to the screenplay. Although Jones received the film's sole screenwriting credit, Labyrinth was shot on location in Upper Nyack, Piedmont, and Havistra in New York, and at Elstree Studios and West Wickham Park in the United Kingdom. The New York Times reported that Labyrinth had a budget of $25 million. The film was a box office disappointment, grossing $12.9 million. During its U.S. theatrical run, the commercial failure demoralized Henson to the extent that his son Brian remembered the time of the film's release as one of the most difficult periods of his father's career. It would be the last feature film directed by Henson before his death in 1990. Although it was met with a mixed critical response upon its initial release, Labyrinth has since gained a large cult following. A four-volume comic sequel to the film, Return to Labyrinth, was published by Tokyo Pop between 2006 and 2010. In 2012, Arkaya Studios Press announced they were developing a graphic novel prequel to the film. In January 2016, it was announced that a reboot was in development, which was later denied by screenwriter Nicole Perlman, describing it instead as a spin-off in the same fictional universe. Plot. 15-year-old Sarah Williams rehearses a play in the park with her dog Merlin, but becomes distracted by a line she is unable to remember while being watched by a barn owl. Realizing she is late to babysit her baby brother Toby, she rushes home and is confronted by her stepmother Irene before she and her father Robert leave for dinner. Sarah has many toys that she has grown out of, and realizes that Toby is in possession of her treasured teddy bear Lancelot. Frustrated by this and his constant crying, Sarah rashly wishes Toby be taken away by the Goblin King Jareth, a character in the play she is rehearsing. She is shocked when Toby disappears, and the Goblin King confronts her and transports her to his kingdom. He refuses to return the baby, but gives Sarah 13 hours to solve his labyrinth and find him before Toby is turned into a goblin forever. Sarah meets a dwarfish man named Hoggle, who aids her in entering the labyrinth. She has trouble finding turns and corners, but then meets a talking worm who inadvertently sends her in the wrong direction. Sarah ends up in an oubliette, where she reunites with Hoggle after they confront Jareth and escape one of his traps. The two encounter a large beast named Ludo. Hoggle flees in a cowardly fashion while Sarah befriends Ludo. After another riddle, she loses him in a forest. Hoggle encounters Jareth, who gives him a drugged peach and instructs him to give it to Sarah, calling his loyalty into question, as he was supposed to lead her back to the beginning of the maze. Sarah is assaulted by a group of creatures called Fieries with detachable body parts who try to remove her head, but Hoggle comes to her aid. She kisses him, and Jareth magically sends them to the Bog of Eternal Stench as punishment, where they reunite with Ludo. Sarah, Hoggle, and Ludo meet a guard of the bridge out of the swamp named Sir Didymus, an anthropomorphic fox, and his old English sheepdog, steed, named Ambrosius. After Ludo howls and summons a trail of rocks to save Sarah from falling into the bog, Didymus joins the group. After the group gets hungry, Hoggle gives Sarah the peach and runs away as she falls into a trance and begins to lose her memories. She has a dream where Jareth comes to her at a masquerade ball, proclaiming his love for her, but she begins to remember and escapes, falling into a junkyard. After an old junk lady fails to brainwash her and her memory is jogged, she is rescued by Ludo and Didymus. and they are right outside Goblin City near Jareth's castle. They are confronted by the gate guard, but Hoggle bravely comes to their rescue. Despite his feeling unworthy of forgiveness for his betrayal, Sarah and the others welcome him back, and they enter the city together. Jareth is alerted to their presence and sends his goblin army to stop them, but Ludo howls and summons a mountain's worth of rocks to chase the guards away, and they enter the castle. Sarah insists she must face Jareth alone and promises to call the others if needed. In a room modeled after an Escher staircase drawing, she confronts Jareth while trying to retrieve Toby. She recites the lines from her play that mirror her adventure to that point, but she still cannot remember the last line. As Jareth begs her to fear him and obey him, promising he will love her and give her anything she wants, she remembers the line, "You have no power over me," defeated at the last second. Jareth returns Sarah and Toby home safely and turns into a barn owl, flying away. Realizing how important Toby is to her, Sarah gives him Lancelot and returns to her room. After she hears her father and stepmother come in, she sees her friends in the mirror and realizes even though she is growing up, she still needs them in her life every now and again. In an instant, a number of the major characters from the Labyrinth appear in her room for a raucous celebration, and she reunites with Hoggle, Ludo, Didymus, and Ambrosius. As they celebrate, Jareth, in his owl form, watches from outside and then flies away into the night. Influences. Richard Corliss noted that the film appeared to have been influenced by The Wizard of Oz in the works of Maurice Sendak, writing, "Labyrinth lures a modern Dorothy Gale out of the drab Kansas of real life into a land where the wild things are." Nina Donton wrote that the plot of Labyrinth is very similar to Outside Over There by Mr. Sendak, in which 9-year-old Ida's baby sister is stolen by the goblins. Copies of Outside Over There and Where the Wild Things Are shown briefly in Sarah's room at the start of the film, along with copies of Alice in Wonderland, The Wizard of Oz, a book by Hans Christian Andersen, Grimm's Fairy Tales and Walt Disney's Snow White. The film also features an end credit stating, "Jim Henson acknowledges his debt to the works of Maurice Sendak." The film's concept designer Brian Froud has stated that the character of Jareth was influenced by a diverse range of literary sources. In his afterword to The Goblins of Labyrinth, Froud wrote that Jareth references the romantic figures of Heathcliff in Wuthering Heights, and a brooding Rochester from Jane Eyre, and the Scarlet Pimpernel. Bowie's costumes were intentionally eclectic, drawing on the image of Marlon Brando's leather jacket from The Wild One as well as that of a knight, with the worms of death eating through his armor, from the fairy tales of the Brothers Grimm. The dialogue starting with phrase, "You remind me of the babe," that occurs between Jareth and the goblins in the magic dance sequence in the film, is a direct reference to an exchange between Cary Grant and Shirley Temple in the 1947 film The Bachelor and the Bobby Soxer. Origins and script. According to the film's conceptual designer Brian Froud, Labyrinth was first discussed between himself and director Jim Henson. Both agreed to work on another project together, and Froud suggested that the film should feature goblins. On the same journey, Froud pictured a baby surrounded by goblins. And this strong visual image, along with Froud's insight that goblins traditionally steal babies, provided the basis for the film's plot. Discussing the film's origins, Henson explained that he and Froud wanted to do a light-to-weight picture with more of a sense of comedy, since Dark Crystal got kind of heavier than we had intended. "Now I wanted to do a film with the characters having more personality and interacting more." Labyrinth was being seriously discussed as early as March 1983, when Henson held a meeting with Froud and children's author Dennis Lee. Lee was tasked with writing a novella on which a script could be based, submitting it at the end of 1983. Henson approached Terry Jones to write the film's script, as his daughter Lisa had just read Eric the Viking, and suggested that he try me as screenwriter. Jones was given Dennis Lee's novella to use as a basis for his script, but later told Empire that Lee had produced an unfinished, poetic novella that he didn't really get on with. In light of this, Jones discarded it and sat down with Brian Froud's drawings and sifted through them and found the ones that I really liked, and started creating the story from them. While Jones is credited with writing the screenplay, the shooting script was actually a collaborative effort that featured contributions from Henson, George Lucas, Laura Phillips, and Elaine May. Jones himself has said that the finished film differs greatly from his original vision. According to Jones, "I didn't feel that it was very much mine. I always felt it fell between two stories. Jim wanted it to be one thing and I wanted it to be about something else." Jones has said his version of the script was about the world, and about people who are more interested in manipulating the world than actually bearing themselves at all. In Jones's original script, Jareth merely seems all-powerful to begin with, and is actually using the labyrinth to keep people from getting to his heart. Jones has said that Bowie's involvement in the project had a significant impact on the direction taken with the film. Jones had originally intended for the audience not to see the center of the labyrinth prior to Sarah's reaching it, as he felt that doing so robbed the film of a significant hook. With the thought of Bowie starring in the film in mind, Henson decided he wanted Jareth to sing and appear throughout the film, something Jones considered to be the wrong decision. Despite his misgivings, Jones rewrote the script to allow for songs to be performed throughout the film. This draft of the script went away for about a year, during which time it was redrafted first by Laura Phillips and subsequently by George Lucas. An early draft of the script attributed to Jones and Phillips is markedly different from the finished film. The early script has Jareth enter Sarah's house in the guise of Robin Zucker, the author of a play she is due to perform in. Sarah does not wish for her brother to be taken away by the goblins, and Jareth snatches him away against her will. Jareth is overtly villainous in this draft of the script, and during his final confrontation with Sarah he tells her he would much rather have a queen than a little goblin prince. The early script ends with Sarah kicking Jareth in disgust, her blows causing him to transform into a powerless, sniveling goblin. In the extensive junkyard scene, Jareth operates the junk lady as a puppet, whereas in the film she is autonomous. There is actually a pub or bar in the labyrinth where the man with hat and hoggle gather, and the river Lethe in Greek myth is mentioned. As well, the ballroom scene features extensive dialogue between Jareth and Sarah, whereas in the film there is none, and the goings-on with the dancers in the ballroom are more overtly sexualized. The redrafted script was sent to Bowie, who found that it lacked humor and considered withdrawing his involvement in the project as a result. To ensure Bowie's involvement, Henson asked Jones to do a bit more to the script in order to make it more humorous. Elaine May met with Henson several months prior to the start of filming in April 1985, and was asked to polish the script. May's changes humanized the characters and pleased Henson to the extent that they were incorporated into the film's shooting script. At least 25 treatments and scripts were drafted for Labyrinth between 1983-85, and the film's shooting script was only ready shortly before filming began. Brought to you by WikiVidi Documentaries. Would you like